Tonight's presentation, a concert, Jazz in RockTown, a Jazz in the RockTown. It's brought to you by the RockTown Community Performing Arts with Rojay Moore as the Managing and Artistic Director. We're so happy you could come tonight, you're a beautiful audience. Man, we are kind of reliving history. Man, in a historic location, listening to legendary music from legendary artists. We are so pleased that you would join us tonight. Just in the way of housekeeping, please, would you please silence your phones and electronic devices, please? If you did not rehearsal, if you did not rehearse, you cannot sit in tonight, so no special effects. But while you have them out, please, I want to direct your attention to a website, www.teen-u.org. You can download a digital playbill of tonight's performance. So that's www.teen-u.org. Got that? All right. After the concert, there'll be a brief photo shoot with the members of the band and the guest performers, so get your cameras and so forth ready for then. One other thing, please, I think. After the concert, I've already said that. Tell you what, without any further delay, please welcome to the stage the RockTown Jazz Orchestra with Rojay Moore. How about a big hand?
Y'all look so nice out there. I appreciate you all coming out tonight for our second Jazz in the RockTown event for this school year. We're actually going to do a series of these throughout the year. This is our second one, then our next one is going to be this fall. We're going to be playing the music of New Orleans. So tonight we're going to be featuring the music of Duke Ellington. How many of you heard Duke Ellington before? All right. So hopefully you all recognize some of the songs, but what we're going to do tonight, we're going to play some of the earlier period songs from like the 1920s and the early 30s, and then we're gonna make our way to the 60s and the 70s right before he passed in 1974. So Duke Ellington was born right at the turn of the 20th century. He was born in 1899, April the 29th, 1899. This first song that we're gonna open up for you is entitled East St. Louis Toodaloo, and it was actually recorded in 1926 by his original small group called the Washingtonians. He was from Washington, D.C. And so this is our opening selection. Now let's hear it again for the RockTown Jazz Orchestra.
Oh,
solo, we have Tricky B. We call him Tricky B. Roger. And on the clarinet solo, we have Mr. J.J. McJunkins.
Right, so we're going to move right along. Hopefully you all did get a chance to go to our website, www.teen-u.org. The letter U, teen-u.org. There's an incredible playbill that's been put together with all the liner notes of the songs that we'll be playing tonight. Nicely, professionally taken photos, actually, of all the musicians in the jazz orchestra, and several pictures of Duke Ellington, and some little program notes that I've put in the program as well. Also, to the last page, it has the history of the Rocktown Community Performing Arts, and it goes back to May of 2015. So if you get a chance, we'd like for you to download the playbill. And it saved us a lot of money by doing the digital format too. So we want you to be able to access that on our website. We're going to move along in the program. Our next selection is entitled The Mooch. Does anybody in the band want to tell the story behind what The Mooch is all about? All right. They don't know. I'm always putting them on the spot to see how much they're actually listening in rehearsals when we're teaching them things about the songs. So this is Christopher Crutchfield. This is our baritone saxophone.
Basically, the mooch is about someone that's like always trying to take your money or get something from you. You know, you always have the person in the neighborhood that's creeping up to you, like, hey, can I get a dollar? Hey, can I get $5? You know, so this is about the mooch. I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
on the solo, we had back there in the trumpet section, Mr. White Chocolate, Mason Burns. Give it up. On the trombone solo, we had Brian Nooker. And the clarinet solo, all the way from New Orleans, Louisiana, Mr. J.J. McJunkins. Bring up our special guest from the evening. Now, this is a big occasion for me because when I was these students' age, not that I'm much, I probably look their age still, but not that I'm much older than them, but when I was their age, junior in high school actually, I was put on to a group in New York City called, at the time it was called Lincoln Center Jazz Orchestra, and that phenomenal organization and jazz ensemble is led by Wynton Marsalis. Anybody familiar with Wynton Marsalis? All right, we're working on trying to get him to Little Rock soon. But this individual performs with the Lincoln Center Jazz Orchestra. It's now called the Jazz at Lincoln Center Orchestra. And he's been performing with them and touring around the world for 25 years. I believe since 94, I believe it was. 1994 is when he has joined the band. And he was telling us a story about when he first joined the band, he was actually one of the youngest cats in the orchestra. And now he's the fourth oldest cat in the jazz orchestra. But he still plays like a youngster up in New York City. This is our guest artist from the Jazz at Lincoln Center Orchestra. He's got several CDs out. I think it may be around 8 or 9. I'm not sure if you can tell you more about it. But he's got several. I've got some downloaded. You can actually go to Apple Music and download his music from Apple Music as well. So I highly encourage. You're going to be very, very inspired tonight to hear his soulful trumpet playing. None other than Mr. Marcus Printup. Give it up.
Thank you so much. I actually decided to kind of walk out with a limp so you guys would think I was really old. Hey, but it's such a pleasure to be here. This is the first time that I've been to Little Rock. We've been to Fayetteville, and I think we played in Pine Bluff, or we did something in Pine Bluff, and I've been around the city to see all the historical sites, and I'm very touched to be here, and it's very touched to be here with this wonderful band. Let's give them a round of applause. That's a nice segue, because the next song is a song I wrote about my high school band director, and I want to acknowledge Rojay for doing such a great job with them as well, so let's give it up to Rojay. He approached me to do this last year, and he is so passionate about these kids, so passionate about this community, and I'm just honored to be here, to be a part of all of it. So, good job, man. Where you at? I'm gonna sing, he's back to hide. So, but this song is about, my middle school band director, his name was David Hudson, it still is David Hudson, but he was a bishop, and he passed away about 8 or 9 years ago, and we reconnected after, you know, I started being almost kind of successful doing what I'm doing, and we got very close. And I wrote this song after he passed away. It is entitled The Bishop. Hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
Cam CandySoul.